to you and thanks for joining us tonight on your one and only program, Questions in the Heart. How was your bank holiday yesterday? I had fun. It was lovely. It was a lovely day for me, a very memorable one. I hope you enjoyed your day as well. Well, look forward to another holiday and plan ahead. Make the most of it. Tonight, we're going to go back, you know, on that lovely topic, the topic you won't allow us to let go of, divorce. By popular demand, we're doing one more episode tonight on divorce, then we'll let the case rest a bit, pick up another topic and, you know, maybe revisit the topic some other time. But before I go on tonight's episode, on tonight's show, the BBC recently picked on Pentecostal churches and Pentecostal pastors, saying they're putting pressure on people not to take their medication, you know, encouraging people to believe in miracles and faith and you know, depriving them the opportunity of, you know, having access to proper medical treatments using their medication and stuff. And just last week, the Cameroon president put a permanent stop or shut down completely Pentecostal churches in Cameroon. The president shut down completely over 100 Pentecostal churches in Cameroon for fake miracles. What is the hope of the church? Where is faith going? What is the church becoming? Is the church in safe hands? We're going to do a serious talk on this issue on Questions in the Heart. I want you to get ready. Watch out for this episode. We'll try as much as possible to get all our leaders, some of them, you know, prominent leaders, to come on this show and talk to us and tell us what they think the future of the church is going to be. If a whole country will shut down Pentecostal churches for fake miracles, and BBC here also, you know, picked on us as well. What's going on? What's the problem? How do we address it? Is there hope for the church? Is the church in safe hands? Watch out for that episode. But tonight, like I said, we'll do the last episode for now on divorce. And I've got, well, today is a man in the house. Someone called in last week saying, oh, I'm glad we had ladies on the show talking about this. It's not men talking about it. It's ladies' thing and ladies are dealing with it. But tonight, we've got a man in the house. And I hope he will be able to do justice to some of your questions that you've asked us, you know, week before last week. And tonight, I believe you'll be inspired. I'll go on a commercial break. Please don't call my mobile number. The studio line to call will be on the screen soon. I'll go on a short break. When I return, you get to meet my guest. Don't touch the dial. See you soon.
We are here only because of you. If Questions in the Heart have been a blessing, we would ask of you to please sow towards our ministry so we can keep doing what we do. Please support us. Our website address is www.questionsintheheart.com. Please click on the PayPal link. Telephone 0788-120-7952. As you give towards this work, we can reach more and liberate more. God bless you.
For immigration,
your bar, restaurant, and nightclub. For all your African and continental dishes, come to Afrikiko Restaurant, Bar and Nightclub. Banku and tilapia, fufu, fried yam, pounded yam, egusi, and many more. Excellent food range, fully stocked bar, professional catering services, late night license, Afro entertainment, fully air conditioned. Afrikiko is a perfect spot for your special event, parties, weddings, meetings, and private functions. Call us for a reservation today. Time Monday to Thursday, 12 noon to 1 a.m. Friday to Sunday, 12 noon to 4 a.m. Locate Afrikiko Restaurant, Bar and Nightclub on the Old Kent Road, London SC15-1NX. Telephone 0207-732-4041 or 07903-315150 or visit www.afrikiko.uk.com. Afrikiko Restaurant, Bar and Nightclub, a place to be. Bar, restaurant and nightclub.
Would you love to be part of a family-friendly church where the love is genuine, the worship is intense, and you are well looked after? Then join us at the Chapel of Mercy, Redeemed Christian Church of God, for any of our services. Sunday service, 12:30 p.m. Tuesday Bible study, 7 p.m. On the last Friday of the month, we have our prayer vigil that starts at 10 p.m. We meet at St. George's Hall, St. George's Center, Chippenham Road, Harold Hill, Romford, RM38HX. Bus information is on the screen. Pastor Ola Otegola, Resident Pastor. Pastor E.A. Adeboye, General Overseer. Please do join us and God bless you.
Results. If you are looking for natural hair that does not shed, hair that is light and soft, hair you can run your fingers through and it does not tangle, go for HX Brazilian and Peruvian hair.
I needed hair that would allow me to play my character and be myself offset. Now I can be both and more.
I can go to my meeting with confidence.
I feel simply fabulous.
HX Brazilian and Peruvian hair, the hair that brings out the divalicious in you.
Some calls during the week, people saying, come on Esther, do this show every day. And I'm like, why not? I'm here to serve you. But bring me what to serve you with. You want me on the show every day of the week. I can't do it. I'm ready for you. Support us. We need your help. We need your support to keep Questions in the Heart going. Log on to www.questionsintheheart.com. There is a PayPal link there where you can support us financially. This program is touching lives. It's blessing people. We are in the fourth year. We're trusting God for sponsors. But team up with us, you know. Success is not measured by the amount of cars, houses, or wealth you've got, the amount of money you've got in your bank. That is not the yardstick to measure your success. The yardstick to measure your success is how many people have you been able to impact? How many people can say, thank God for you? Why don't you team up with us? Join us, support us financially, so we can bring you more inspiring programs, so we can come your way every day like you requested. And I know that as you join us on this success journey, God will bless you in return. Log on to www.questionsintheheart.com. The PayPal link is there. Please support us so we can keep coming your way each week. You know, this platform is a platform that you can come and, you know, say your mind fearlessly. You know, people can ask you questions, you can answer, you can say your mind is a platform where the truth must be told. So support us and the Lord bless you as you do. We want to catch up on our past episodes as well. They are there on www.questionsintheheart.com. You've got a message for the world, you want to come on this show, give me a shout. You know, we'll discuss with you and take it up from there. You want to advertise with us, you know, we assure you your business will get to the next level if you do business with us. We are quite affordable. It's a honor to have tonight in the house Prophet Yomi Oni, the Celestial Prophet. Welcome on Questions in the Heart tonight.
Yeah, good evening, Sister Esther. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to you to another episode of Our Question in the Heart. Obviously, this is a program that's been going, as you said, for 4 years
now.
Yeah, we've been touching life, we've been breaking barriers, we've been making people to understand what Christianity is all about.
That's it.
And I think recently you're dealing with the issue of divorce, which, you know, obviously has been dealt with by from the female perspective the last two weeks. And, you know, we're trusting God to give us the honor to be able to answer your question, to shed more light, and to give our guidance, you know, where necessary on this question. Welcome to the program. May the Lord bless you as you watch it.
It's a honor having you on Questions in the Heart again. Well, Prophet Yomi, no offense. When you talk about divorce, polygamy, and all sorts. People want to think, if you refer to that in the church, people's minds quickly jumps up to, oh, CCC. No offense. Tonight, you want to tell me what the stance of CCC is on divorce?
You see, what we need to understand is that the Celestial Church of Christ doesn't support divorce per se, because we've got programs, we've got channels for a marriage ceremony, we got a channel for christening and baby dedication. When people, you know, are sleeping a lot, we got a channel for that, we got programs for that, we got services for that, but we haven't got service for divorce. And that tells you that obviously it's not something that, you know, we support. But
people say it's common with you.
Yeah, I haven't said that. When you read the book of Mark chapter number 10, and the Pharisees asked Jesus, you know, what should I do in the case of divorce? And Jesus asked them back, what did Moses tell you? And they told Jesus, Moses said, you know, if my wife has done this or done that, I should write a bill of divorcement. And Jesus told them that, you know, for the hardness of your heart. And that's why, you know, Moses wrote that law for you. What we need to understand is that, you know, our marriage is a mutual agreement between two people. And if they chose to go, you know, the different part, the pastor, the resident pastor, the vicar, whoever leads the church, is the duty to try to advise them that, listen, this is still workable. We need to find out what are the differences. We need to find out what are the issues. We need to find out what the challenges that are there and see what we can do to resolve.
So are your pastors in CCC not doing their job?
Yeah, the pastors are doing that.
Divorce is on a high side with you.
But, you know, you say divorce is on a higher side in the Celestial Church of Christ. Yeah. Have you been able to measure in other churches, you know?
Well, tonight CCC is the focus for me.
Yeah, I mean, I do appreciate that. Yeah. What I'm saying there is that, you see, people come into a marriage, you know, with a mutual understanding.
Yeah.
And if people are not able to bear it again, having, you know, gone through all the processes, people have spoken with them, they've prayed with them, they've counseled them, and if they chose not to go their different ways, there's little or nothing you can do about it. That's the key thing that we need to understand, that we need to understand as well. Because when you look at the words of Jesus, Jesus is the last authority in everything that we do in this world. And he told the Pharisees, like, listen, Moses wrote that because of your heart. Because your heart is so hard and you don't want to listen to what he wants to say. Mm. And if you're able to listen to him, you'll see reasons, you know, in that. So also in the church that we have today, if a Celestial Church support divorce, we will have made provision for it. That is a process when you want to get divorced. That's a service for, you know, for that. And that is not available.
You
that
don't
is not
support
there.
Divorce, but you support polygamy.
We do not support polygamy.
Well, it's...
We do not support, you know...
it's no news to us.
You know, what you need to understand is that, you know, people that... There's no guiding rule in the church agree with you that you're not allowed to do that. But, as I said in the last few other programs, you know, the new generation of churches, of leaders, or people in the church, and I said, listen, this thing is doing a great damage, a great dent to the church. How do we address this? And a lot of people are, you know, driving forward to ensure that, you know, those things are removed from their lifestyle, looking at their marriages, working it out, looking at the differences, and finding out where they can get issues resolved, rather than, you know, the end process is that, you've done this, I'm going to divorce you.
Okay, should a man or a woman divorce because their spouse have committed adultery? That's the peak of it, isn't it?
That's the peak of it. But what we need to understand is, Jesus, when the woman was caught in adultery, they brought him to Jesus. They did not even look at, you know, a divorcement. They looked at terminating her life. And Jesus told them that, listen, if any one of you have not, you know, committed any sins or any of these things, throw a stone. And nobody was able to, to do that to this woman. There's nothing there. You see, the hardness of our heart as a woman or as a man, it will be the end result of any mutual togetherness between a man and a woman. Mm-hmm. And if the woman say, you know, I cannot handle this anymore, the man said, no, I don't want to listen, you know, she's done that. There's no sin that is not forgivable. There's no sin that if you really love someone, and I'm not saying that, you know, you should go out, you know, committing adultery or, you know, having partners outside of your marriage. But what I'm saying is that we should be able to look beyond that, understanding that, you know, find out what's the reason for that. A man or a woman that you neglect.
We definitely seek for solace somewhere else.
So that is the thing that we need to look at. So it's not a case of, you know, we support divorce, you have to do this, you have to do that. No, you need to look at, you know, what is the stance on this? Because if your wife or your husband commit adultery, shouldn't be the end of it. It's the case of, you know, you sit down, you find out the reason why I can resolve that. But if it is something that ricochet all the time, you know, you spoke about this last week, another thing happened next week again, then it tells you that it is not then a mistake or, you know, a
what
mistake.
If the man or the woman involved is not helping the partner either? If for whatever reason the other partner has been the reason why he's doing what he's doing, or the reason why she's doing what she's doing, and yet he's not changing on his part, she's not changing on her part, and yet expect the man or the woman to stop doing what she's doing.
Yeah, but you know, obviously, if you find out a reason why something is happening and you're not tackling it or you're not dealing with it, it
means that
you're not helping the issue. It's a case of sitting down, having a reality check between, you know, the husband and the wife, find out what's the reason behind this thing. If they have to seek counseling, they have to seek counseling. If they have to seek the face of the Lord, they have to seek the face of the Lord. Find out the reason right behind it. And once they've been able to identify the reason behind it, it is mandatory for the husband or for the wife to sit down and listen, my darling, this is the issue. These are the things that we need to deal with it and just get it off our radar.
Okay, this is a big one for me tonight. The last episode we had, that was last week on divorce, someone caught saying, is it right for someone who's been divorced to remarry? And some people called in to say, no, there is no support of you remarrying. The Bible does not really support someone who's been through divorce to remarry. I'm asking you tonight, should a divorced man or woman remarry?
Listen, because,
and please give me scriptural backing.
Been divorced, or the husband has been divorced, mm-hmm. doesn't mean that should be the end of their life. But if you read the book of Matthew chapter number 10, the Bible tells, Jesus was explicit. Mark chapter number 10. He said, if you curse a woman, if you divorce a woman or divorce a man, mm-hmm. you cause that person to commit adultery. But when we look at the world that we live in now, I don't personally believe that people just divorce for divorce's sake. I mean, there must be some fundamental issues mm-hmm. why the divorce.
Yeah.
And because it doesn't work with someone, does not mean it will not work with someone else. But when we look at statistics, we find out that, you know, the rate of divorce on second time marriage is more than the first time marriage. Why? It is because we're not able to see beyond the obvious that, you know, the first thing that was wrong in my marriage was that, you know, my husband, you know, is a wife, a beat. And I'm not supporting that. What I'm saying, you're trying to find out what is the reason behind you divorcing the first time. The moment you see any iota of such a thing that's happening in the second marriage again, you're just wrong. And that's why you see that even the third one is even more. Because the moment you see something, now I've seen that before, I'm not taking it. Everybody just wrong. It's a case of
you leave your first marriage, it's difficult to end the marriage.
Because the moment you see, you know, you see the parameters, or you see the signs of the reason why the first one went, you just want to, this is the same thing that happened first time, I don't want to see this again, and everybody goes. If you look at the statistics, it's more, the divorce rate of second time marriages or third time marriages are more than the first time marriages. Because obviously, you know, the first time you're still trying to work it out, still trying to find out what are the things that are wrong and trying to sort it out. But when you look at the second one, the moment the spouse or, you know, the husband or the wife sees signs of, you know, not even, you know,
I'm not gonna take this happen before, it's not of my life,
but you know, it is for us to just sit down, find out the reason, and just, you know, and just try to work it out. And after you've tried to work it out, you seek the face of the Lord, you've prayed, you've fasted, you've seek counseling, you've done, you know, you've explored every avenue, then nobody is going to say to you, you know, sit down in an abusive marriage, or sit down in a marriage that, you know, there's violence there, mm-hmm. or in a marriage that there's neglect there. It is, you know, but everybody's, you know, a threshold point and, you know, breaking point are different.
Is there any marriage that is trouble free?
There's none. It's absolutely not. It's a case of we just need to work it out, find out what is wrong. And when people say, you know, I've got the perfect marriage, I kind of life inside. There's things that are wrong, but they're working it out. There are things that are different, because bear in mind that every single person that got into a marriage, maybe the husband comes to a different family, the wife comes to a different family, they're bringing a different, you know, their exposure to life are different. And when you look at within that community, there's quite a few people that are just come from Africa, you know, a year. Someone has been born here, has been living here. Then their orientation are different. Yeah. Their thinking are different. Their lifestyle are different. And you don't expect them to just jump together and start to work on the same vehicle at the same time. It's not going to be like that. There's going to be a grooming period that you used to do, you know, we're coming together now. There's some balances that we need to see there. Mm. Yeah, that's the way I do things as a man before. No, you're in a marriage now, and it's a case of giving and taking and finding. find out where you both, you know, the equilibrium, where you both meet, and find out, you know, sacrifices I can give out for each other.
Wow. Interesting. You've not really answered my question. Mm-hmm. Literally, you said there is no point going for a second marriage if the first one failed, because statistics shows
it is the divorce rate of the first, second one is, and the third one is even more than the first one.
More than the first one. So literally, you're saying no to remarriage.
I'm not saying no to remarriage, because you divorce the first time does not mean that you cannot, you know, you cannot find out the, you know, the reason, you know, why you divorced the first time. Say, listen, any marriage you're going to now, this is the mistake that was made in the first one.
Research shows it's the second marriage.
It is, but you know, it's a case of individual. If some people want to say, you know what, that's happened the first time, I'm just gonna stay on my own.
So what's the biblical stand on this? What's the stance of the Bible on this?
Jesus is explicit, and as I said to you in the book of Mark chapter number 10, Jesus said that if you divorce your wife or your husband, if you know you cause that person to commit adultery. So what technically what Jesus is telling you is that you try and work it out. Obviously if you try and work it out in the marriage, that means you don't remarry.
So you're saying there is no room for remarriage once.
I'm not saying that there's no room for remarriage. It will get to the point that if you are not able to work it out. If you're not totally, you know, if you're every avenue that's...
You can't work it out, you're out of it. Should you go again?
I don't want
you to stand on the fence.
No, I'm not standing on the fence. It's an individual thing. Some people will say, yes,
I want
to...
Is the Bible saying, go again?
The Bible is not saying go again. That Jesus is explicit. And if Jesus tells us in the book of Mark chapter number 10 from verse number 4 downward, he said, if a man leaves a woman, you cause that woman to do what? To commit adultery. Technically Jesus is telling you is that you don't do what? You don't divorce, you stay in your marriage. And if you don't divorce, you don't stay in your marriage, there's no room for a second marriage.
I'm going to go on a short break tonight. Should a man or woman who's been through divorce remarry? Don't touch the dial.
Bar, restaurant, and nightclub. For all your African and continental dishes, come to Afrikiko Restaurant, Bar, and Nightclub. Banku and tilapia, fufu, fried yam, pounded yam, egusi, and many more. Excellent food range, fully stocked bar, professional catering services, late night license, Afro entertainment, fully air conditioned. Afrikiko is a perfect spot for your special event, parties, weddings, meetings, and private functions. Call us for a reservation today. Time Monday to Thursday, 12 noon to 1 a.m. Friday to Sunday, 12 noon to 4 a.m. Locate Afrikiko Restaurant, Bar and Nightclub on the Old Kent Road, London SE15 1NX. Telephone 0207 732 4041 or 07903 315 150, or visit www.afrikiko.uk.com. Afrikiko Restaurant, Bar and Nightclub, a place to be. Afrikiko Bar.
Would you love to be part of a family-friendly church where the love is genuine, the worship is intense, and you are well looked after? Then join us at the Chapel of Mercy, Redeemed Christian Church of God, for any of our services. Sunday service, 12:30 p.m. Tuesday Bible study, 7 p.m. On the last Friday of the month, we have our prayer vigil that starts at 10 p.m. We meet at St. George's Hall, St. George's Center, Chippenham Road, Harold Hill, Romford, RM38HX. Bus information is on the screen. Pastor Ola Otegola, Resident Pastor. Pastor E.A. Adeboye, General Overseer. Please do join us, and God bless you.
Results. If you are looking for natural hair that does not shed, hair that is light and soft, hair you can run your fingers through and it does not tangle, go for HX Brazilian and Peruvian hair.
I needed hair that would allow me to play my character and be myself offset. Now I can be both and more.
I can go to my meeting with confidence.
I feel simply fabulous.
Hair Check's Brazilian and Peruvian hair. The hair that brings out the devilicious in you.
For staying with us on Questions in the Hair. It's been a serious chat tonight with Professor Yomi Oni. And before we went on break, we were talking about remarrying after divorce. Now, what if, well, marriage is till death do us part, for better, for worse. So what if death, the inevitable, took one away?
But
is the other free to remarry?
You've just answered that question. You said, you know, until death do us part.
Okay.
Now, obviously, if death is done, you know, the couple pass, it's a case of, you know, the husband or the wife, if they're willing to remarry, they can, you know, they can do that. But we do have instances of where, you know, there's been the loss of a spouse, the partner say, you know what, that is my life partner.
Again.
I'm not going again. Mm. It's a matter of choice. But about, you know, when you read the vows in the church or in the registry, it's, you know, it's for, you know, for richer, for poorer, you know, for health and in wealth until death do us part. And if death has done them part, and if the other person chooses to remarry, it is a prerogative to do that.
Okay, so remarriage is permitted if there is death, but remarriage is not permitted.
Mm.
With divorce. Our studio line will open tonight. You can call in. I'm a part of this show. Sure. The studio line to call will be on the screen. Please, you can only send text messages to my mobile number in case you're not getting through. I won't be able to take live calls on my mobile number. So you divorced, you don't remarry. There's a lot of partner to death, you're free to remarry. Is that what you're saying?
Jesus said that. He's explicit.
Okay.
Yeah, you know, he said if a man should put away their wife, he said they commit adultery.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, and if the Bible would then say to you, thou shalt not commit adultery, what Jesus is technically saying to us is that
don't put away your wife.
But, you know, as I said, if, you know, there's violence involved, if there's, you know, abuse involved, if there's neglect involved, I'm not saying to you,
Jesus didn't give that clause.
Jesus didn't give that clause, but Jesus is explicit. He said, love your neighbor as yourself. Obviously, for a woman that you love, you're not going to beat that woman. That is the key thing. I mean, for a husband, you know, that you love, you're not going to neglect.
It's even in the scriptures, God doesn't like violence.
Yeah, God doesn't like, you know, like violence. So and for the person that you really love, there's no point. But when we look at, you know, the threshold of an individual are all different. But
it's unfair.
It is unfair.
A woman or a man who, you know, ran out of his or her marriage because of violence, abuse, and stuff,
it is.
Won't have the opportunity to marry again.
That person is scared for life, because obviously it's a case of the moment he sees the man or the woman coming. And I'm not saying that it is only men that are abusive. Sometimes you do get, you know, some women violence as well.
Good evening, thanks for calling.
Yeah, good evening, madam.
Good evening. Prophet Aya, thanks for calling.
And good evening, Prophet Yemi.
Good evening.
How are you?
Hello,
I'm fine, I'm blessed. And yourself?
It's blessed to hear your voice once again after maybe 2 years or 1 year. I was having a little bit argument concerning this a wonderful matter with my lady here. So concerned about the word of our Lord Jesus Christ and what Paul said, and what I said to her, that can a student greater than his master? No. The word of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to what Prophet Yomi has just said now, what that Jesus Christ said, even if you give your wife, you want to divorce your wife, if you divorce your wife because of fornication, you make her also to commit more.
Yeah.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
That is the word of Christ.
Christ, yeah.
Never change. And in the book of Mark, chapter 10, as he said also, that it is only because of you people make moves, you force moves.
You force them to do it.
Divorce. Law.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not because the law is coming from our Lord, from God. Mm. You forced him to do that, and he gave you free will that it is your will, but it is not God's will.
Yeah.
Mm. So we should try to understand that if Paul, I didn't say all what Paul wrote, it is not right or it's not good, but can we live what our Lord Christ, what comes out of his mouth, the Holy Spirit, can we live that? Any other one? It's a question of Prophet Yomi.
Yeah, I mean, Christ is the ultimate and final authority in Christendom. Mm. And if Christ is explicit and has told us that, listen, if you leave your wife or you leave your husband, you make that person to commit adultery. What Jesus is telling us is that, you should try and work it out. If you made that vow that, listen, I'm with you in rich, in health, until death, do what part. And, when we look at marriages as well, if there's any, I mean, it was sweet when they started, and if it's getting sour after a while, if you look at the book of 2 Chronicles chapter number 17, verse 14, the Bible is explicit. It says, if I send famine to any land, I mean, when you look at marriages, when it's not working, it means there's a famine there, there's some issues there. And the key word there is that if they shall humble themselves, seek my face and pray, I will heal their land. So it's a case of, the husband being humble, the wife being humble, and seeking the face of the Lord, that God, we need your hand in this.
My concern tonight is, for instance, a woman who is married to an unbelieving husband, and the guy is not willing to change. If the unbelieving husband walks away himself, is this woman free to remarry?
But what we need to understand as well, when you read the book of Genesis chapter number 24, where Abraham, asked his servant to choose his wife for his son, he said, don't choose a wife from the Canaanites. Choose a wife from my people. Now, if you are a believer, and you're not married an unbeliever, it's treading on dangerous ground.
It's happened. How do you deal with it?
It's happened. But it's a case of, maybe when you are courting, it should have been, I can't say an agreement per se, that, listen, this is my belief, this is my faith, these are the things that we need to do, these are the way that we need to go. And I believe, if you are a real practicing Christian, when you speak with your pastor, the pastor will probably say to you, your wife or your husband-to-be, let's, sit down, let's counsel ourselves together. But if there are signs from the beginning that the wife or the husband doesn't want to follow your faith, doesn't believe in Jesus Christ, doesn't want to go down the way that you're going with the Lord, it's telling you at the beginning that he's bound to eat the rock.
So how will someone who's been through divorce and was saying tonight is not permitted to remarry deal with emotions and sexual desires? Good evening, Bolaji, thanks for calling.
Good evening. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you for what you're doing.
Thank you.
I just want to ask Professor Tony a question.
Okay.
I mean, what do you consider as a marriage? Do you consider the introduction that parents have made as a marriage, or the engagement, or the church ceremony, sir?
Okay.
But you said it as well. You said introduction.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't say marriage. It's an introduction to marriage. It is not the marriage itself. It's the case of, we're going to this marriage, I need to know your family. Your family needs to know mine. Then the next step is, okay, we've known each other. Are this family compatible? Is this thing that you want to follow on? Then the case of, okay, we've done the introduction. We've known this family. It's a family that can marry into. They then go for the proper, the marriage, where the vows are read. Because I don't think that when you're doing the introduction, the vows are read there. Mm-hmm. It's a case of, you probably sing
family
or a family meeting and all those. But until the actual vows have been read, and there's been a change of vows, there's been a change of ring, and it is solidified by prayers by the ministers, and in some cases where they have Holy Communion, their first Holy Communion together, then that is where the actual marriage took place. The first part that you say is an introduction. When you read a book, when you open the first page of the book, it will say introduction. That does not confine the actual book itself. It's introducing you to the book. So that introduction or engagement is actually, introducing you to the art of marriage.
Okay. I hope that answers your question.
Yes,
God bless you. Thanks for calling. You're still there. Please, when you call, drop the line, listen to the response of the prophet, so that some other people can have access to the studio line. My concern tonight is, we're saying, once you're divorced, you can't remarry. There are Christians, I've seen ministers, Christians, highly placed ministers who are divorced and then remarried. There are examples of them all around us. But now, if we're saying the word of God is the ultimate, which I believe in any situation, how should someone who is divorced and is not permitted to remarry undo sexual and emotional desires?
Okay, you see,
are we going to deny that those are no more there because he's divorced, those part of his life or her life is gone?
That part of their life is not gone.
How do they deal with it?
You see, and that's why I said to you, it's a matter of choice. I mean, that's our threshold are different. There's a lot of people that Paul was explicit.
It's a matter of choice. You can't take it anymore. You are out of it. You can't go and remarry. You have to deal with your emotions. You've got sexual needs. How do you handle it?
When you move from the word of Jesus, you know, when Paul was talking to Timothy, one of his disciples, said to him, you know, I'm not married.
1 minute, sir. Good evening, Michael. Hello, good evening. Hello, Michael.
Hello.
Hello, thanks for calling.
Hello.
Hello, speak on, please.
Hello, my question is, if it's for a child, will come to divorce?
Come again, please. Hello, Michael.
If it's for a child, will come to divorce?
It's not fair on children because, you know, when you look at divorce, you know, a divorce caused, you know, a lot of distress to the children. It caused a lot of distress to the husband, to the wife. It caused a lot of distress to their finances. It caused a lot of distress to the whole, you
it's
know.
It's not fair on
it's,
children.
It's not fair on children because, obviously, you know, children are supposed to be brought up by, you know, both. Both apparent.
Yeah.
But when we look at the world that we are today now, when you go on the internet, you can even see divorce is probably cheap. You know, you probably see divorce for £65, divorce for for £39, and if a lot of people are not, oh, this is so cheap, I can do it. But we're forgetting that there are children involved. You know, and when you
think
see,
of it, Professor Yomi, is not divorce is not fair. It's not fair.
It's not fair at all.
On the children or kids. But is it fair for kids to witness violence, abuse, and all sorts in marriage? Hold on for me, please. Good evening, Boye. Thanks for calling. Hello, Boye.
Yeah. Good evening.
Thanks for calling.
Good evening, sisters.
Good evening, sir.
Yes, sisters, I thank God for your life, for everything that the Lord is doing through you.
Thank you, sir. Hello?
And Brother Yomi, I thank God also for your life.
Oh, God bless you.
But it's very important for us to say the truth.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the truth is the word of God. And I would like you to go to 1 Corinthians chapter 7. When you leave the program, it's very important. I believe that whosoever divorced is possible for them to remarry in order not to commit adultery. God doesn't want adultery. And we know quite all right, it's what you know, Prophet Yomi, that is going on also in Celestial Church.
Mm-hmm.
Right? That they leave the family, the wife outside, and they run after many women outside. It's not a good thing as a Christian. If we want to live as a Christian, we have to live according to the Word of God. Because I know something, that many, they don't believe in Apostle Paul. But Apostle Paul is anointed by God to do the will of the Lord. And his advice to us is very important.
Okay.
We should not put him aside.
Okay, thank you so very much. We appreciate
this is my contribution. God bless you.
Thank you so much.
You.
We appreciate your call. Someone sent a text saying, 1 Corinthians 7:5. If the unbeliever leaves, let it be so. The brother or the sister is not bound in such circumstances. God has called us to leave in peace.
Yeah, God has that, and that's why I gave you the example of Genesis chapter number 24. You see, if you are a believer,
he just asked you the same question I asked.
No, he has
divorce, don't remarry. How do you undo your knee?
Okay, when you look at what Jesus said, I don't understand what you're saying from Apostle Paul, but what we have to look at, you know, the parameters here is the words of Apostle Paul overbearing on the words of Jesus, because Jesus is explicit. He said, if you divorce your wife, you cause that person to commit adultery.
Good evening, Simon. Thanks for calling.
Well, good evening. Good evening for such a wonderful program. It's one of
Thank
the crucial
you.
Factors and crucial issues that is running around the world today, that we as Christians and non-Christians, all of us, have been affected by being committed and being submissive to the word of God. Apart from that, I really want to thank God for Prophet being this kind of being part of parcel of this wonderful topic. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you so much. We appreciate you. He's saying it is a serious issue that is affecting everybody.
It is affecting everybody. It's not just celestial. It's not just Pentecostal or other churches. It is affecting everybody. And when we look at that,
can I say?
Okay, go ahead, please.
Yeah. My hope is that marriage is like trust in God. You trust in God even if things doesn't work out. You trust in God to the extent that if things happen, you trust God. If nothing things happen, you still trust God. And that's how marriage is. If things doesn't work out, you are still married. If things doesn't work out, you still married. That's why before you marry, you need to say three times, do I am really ready for this thing? Because once I'm in, there is no way out. And when we go according to the Bible, there is nothing like remarriage. You cannot re-trust God. You just need to trust God.
I don't have to trust God to make it work. Okay, we appreciate your call tonight. Thank you so very much. You just have to trust God to make it work. But we've seen situations around us. We've seen examples of people who has not worked with them. They walked out and entered another one. The word of God is the authority. Whatever we do as Christians, the word of God is the has the final say on issues. I'm not disputing that. How do we handle if tonight your stance is the Bible says once you divorce you should not remarry, or the Bible is saying don't divorce at all, and you're saying once you're divorced that's it, don't go for another one, like the caller before this one said, how do they then deal with their sexual desire? Should someone who's been divorced then go up from bed to bed or go into another marriage?
See, if we keep going around, we're going to be going around in circles.
Okay, answer that question for the last time. Yeah.
But Jesus said, this is this the stand. And obviously, if one cannot contain themselves, when you look at what Jesus said at the beginning, he asked them, what did Moses say? They said, Moses asked us to give the bill of divorcement. They told them that it is because of the hardness of your
heart. Good evening.
That is why Moses gave that. So if Jesus has said something, we can always say, you know what, Jesus?
What about this? Okay, good evening, thanks for calling.
Hello, good evening.
Hello, God bless you.
God bless you. I'm calling in because I wanted to highlight some Bible texts with regards to the question of divorce. And one was in Matthew 19, verse 9, where it clearly says that the reason for divorce, whoever shall put away his wife except for fornication and shall marry again, committeth adultery, and whosoever marrieth her, doth commit adultery. So that is very clear that on the basis of remarrying after a divorce, the Bible is saying that if you do that, then the person you're going to marry is committing adultery. It's clear that the Lord is, Jesus is explicitly telling us that we cannot do that. Also, in 1 Corinthians 7 and verse 11, where it highlights that if a woman or whoever should leave their partner, they should remain on their own and then go back to their partner at such a time. So in cases of abuse and neglect and where it's not healthy and safe for the people in that marriage to continue cohabitating, then we've been given that permission that you can leave, whereas seeking the help that you need to restore your marriage and then going back after and seeking the face of the Lord. So even in that sense, they haven't been divorced. And I take the other caller who called in and talked about verse 5 in that same 1 Corinthians 7, where he's highlighting about the unbeliever. But in that text, Paul is addressing people who were not yet in Christ, in the body of Christ, and who've converted because they've received the message of truth and they accepted Christ as their Savior. And they've now become Christians and walking that life. Whereas their partner now decides, you know, you can't do this, then Paul was saying to them, if your husband or wife then decides to leave, you're free to remarry.
Okay. We appreciate your call, Kenya. Thank you so very much. You've done a bit of justice to that tonight. Yeah. You want to continue with what you're saying before I take this next time?
When you look at Jesus, it's his place. He said, what God has joined together,
Let no man put asunder. And but when we look at the basis of marriage, it's like you're going to marry with someone that you love. The base, the, you know, the grassroots of it is about love. Mm-hmm. And if you love someone, you won't be, you know, you won't be violent toward them. Mm-hmm. If you love someone, you won't neglect them. But we have instances where, you know, things happen and, you know, everybody goes their own way. But what I'm trying to say to us, that, you know, I'm not saying that it is a matter of choice. Mm-hmm. I can, you know, quote every single verse in the Bible for you tonight. Wow, I can give you from Genesis to Revelation. You still can't do what you're gonna do.
What do you mean, Ogo? Thanks for calling.
Hello.
Hi. Thanks for calling from Ireland.
Yeah. Please, Pastor Prophet, God bless you.
Good evening. God bless you too.
So there is what I want to contribute is that, you know, actually, somebody who is divorced can get remarried, because most of marriage at the beginning is not designed by God. Somebody can, like some people got married by using love potion against the other one. So that marriage at the beginning is not the marriage that God designed for the two people. So at the end of it, when the divorce comes, they will still go and marry the person that God has designed for them. So any marriage that the hand of God is not upon, no matter what you do, no matter the counseling, no matter anything, it must still collapse, because the foundation of that marriage is not from God. So whereas marriage is what God designed for each person, I will say that God brings out the leaves from a man and created a woman. So every woman has his own matching. So when you go and bring size 40 and put in size 42, it can never be worked out. So if people who are divorced are entitled to marry, are entitled to, you know, you move into another relationship and get married, if God designed that one for them, they must take their foundation as well.
That's another dimension. Thank you so very much. We appreciate your content.
What we need to understand is, if you get a foundation right, I mean, the foundation of what you're talking about is not right, because obviously when you look at what you're talking about, you know, love portion and all this and that.
If the foundation is not right, the Bible says God ate the verse. Like Ogo is saying now, you're going wrong the first time. That is the real man. Then the partner was waiting somewhere.
Leave the foundation.
So leave the old one. Pick up the human.
You see, if the foundation is wrong, you know, if you are a believer, the foundation should not be wrong. If you follow the precept of what the Lord has said, there is a resident pastor, there is a vicar in your church, and I believe that there are the guidelines for marriage.
We
still get it wrong. We can go to, you know, every pastor that is in the house, we can go to every place, we still get it wrong. But what we need to understand, that the reason why we, you know, even when we get it wrong, there's still ways that we can mend it.
Okay.
But where the husband doesn't want to, you know, humble themselves, rather than not humble themselves.
What do we do? Good evening, Bolade. Thanks for calling.
Good evening.
Good evening, sir.
We keep close to what Prophet Amir is doing.
Thank God.
My contribution is this: whether you remarry or you don't remarry, the most important thing is your relationship with God. Remembering that the Bible says, Jesus told us in the scriptures that there is no marriage in heaven. You don't give in marriage, you don't take into marriage in heaven.
Mm-hmm.
Your relationship with God is the most important thing. If you are divorced, you want to marry, you want to remarry, go ahead and remarry.
Go ahead, regardless of what the word of God is saying.
If you know you cannot hold yourself
from your own Bible and do your own will, Commandment number 11.
Yes, the important thing is your relationship with God. Your relationship with God matters.
If you have a relationship with God, then you should be keen about doing His will.
And if you have a relationship with God,
and you want to do things your own way, from your own Bible, make your own laws.
Not doing things your own way. If you are not careful, and you go, you say you want to stay on your own without getting another woman or getting another man, by so doing, you might cross the line of God.
So are you saying if the word of God doesn't suit you in one situation, drop it
and pick up another one?
From your own will, make your own.
Be honest with ourselves. How many Christians these days?
It's not about what the word of God is saying.
We do not.
If people are not doing it, doesn't make it wrong.
As Christians, as believers, we don't need to tie our hands and legs together.
What a Bible there for as a manual?
Anyway, just like Prophet Yomi said.
I just want you to clarify that. Are you saying the Bible is so flexible? If it's suitable for us, mark it.
If it's not,
go ahead. If it's not suitable, cross it out. Make an alternative.
Let's be honest with ourselves. The word of God is direct and is specific.
You're contradicting yourself now.
No.
You're contradicting yourself. If the word of God is sure, if it's real, if it's the final, why should you say if we can't come up with it, we drop it? And
for us to know the word of God, another thing is for us to balance it.
I think,
where is the balance in this?
When you're saying that, you know,
bring your will into the will of God, is that the balance?
When you're saying that there's no marriage in them, what Christ is telling us tentatively is that for you to, you know, the criterion for getting to the kingdom of heaven hasn't got nothing to do with, you know, you're married or, you know, or not. It's what you do on earth. So when Jesus said there's no marriage in heaven, what he's telling us is that, you know, up there it is what you have done on earth that will take you there. It doesn't talk about, you know, it doesn't say that you should not marry. And it doesn't say that, you know, once this one doesn't suit you, you drop it, pick up another one.
My dear prophet in Christ, what you do on earth, that does not earn you the kingdom of God. It does not. It is your faith in Jesus Christ that will earn you the kingdom of God.
If you have faith in Jesus Christ and you don't believe what he says?
It is your faith in Jesus Christ that will earn you the kingdom of God.
So why?
If you have, what faith is talking about, that means that if you have faith in Christ, that means you are faithful to Christ. That means that you follow what Christ has said.
It's even in the Bible that those that do his will are his own. So how will you not do the will of God?
You are my friends if you do that which I command you.
If you don't do his will, if you don't live according to goodness me.
You see,
thanks for calling.
What we need to understand that the Bible is open to interpretation. There are a lot of people we tend to interpret it to suit our purposes.
That's a new word.
Forgetting that, you know, the Bible is explicit, is specific, is, you know, is to the point. And if you believe in Christ, that means you will believe in what he has told you to do.
And you are my friend
if you do that which I command you to do.
Okay, well, we live in the world that things are difficult, it's not easy to do the will of God, and so we can manipulate and chop and change.
And that is what has got the world to where it is now. Well, you know,
be perfect as your Father in heaven is perfect. That was what the Bible told us. It's a honor having you on Questions That I Had Tonight, Prophet Yomi. It's a pity we can't really.
I've got
several text messages
we can always deal with that, you know, offline.
Can you see?
Yeah, I can see.
Questions.
You know,
support us so we can come your way every day. Log on to www.questionsintheart.com. I've got to go tonight. 1 hour is not even enough for us on this show. I've got about nearly 10 or more text messages as questions. Yeah, we can't treat them as questions. We can't treat. Log on to www.questionsintheart.com. That is a place to support us there. PayPal is there. Support us. Let's, you know, come your way more than once a week so you can have time to ask your questions, make your contributions. www.questionsintheart.com. Prophet Yomi, the Lord bless and increase you. We appreciate you. We'd love to see you again on Questions in the Heart. Till I see you, same time, same station next week, the Word of God has got the final say. That's the Maker's Manual. Don't have commandment number 11. He ends as 10. I'll see you next week. God bless you.
God bless
Bye-bye.
You.
Bye. Thanks for calling. All you callers, we love you. Bye. Thanks. Thank you so much for coming. We appreciate it.